Coming up in the news, President Nana Akufo-Addo attends Thanksgiving service a day after his investiture at Chebi. A very good evening and welcome. This is the news and we are coming to you live on your all-news channel, GBC24. We are also live on Ghana Television. My name is Akpene Avo. Thank you so much for joining us. In the details this evening, GBC24 visited the Black Star Square 24 hours after the investiture of President Nana Akufo-Addo and reports that workers were busily putting the place in order. While waste management groups cleaned up the venue, other companies were spotted removing their hardware.
It is common to see volumes of waste generated at venues after an event, usually in the open. The Black Star Square is the ceremonial grounds for almost all national events. The place is maintained from time to time to preserve and extend its lifespan. On the 7th of January 2017, the Independence Square once again lived to tax, with people from across the globe witnessing the swearing-in of the President Nana Akufo-Addo. One can only imagine the amount of filth left by the over 10,000 guests and citizens.
What we did during the program was also to place containers at vantage places, and we also placed part of our staff, our YEA operatives, across the grounds, and they were picking and taking waste during the program. And we have to also commend the security agencies. They were in fact very helpful, and they worked with us closely to ensure that all our waste bins were manned and protected, and make sure that people put their waste into their bins.
As at 11 a.m. when GBC24 got to the Independence Square, workers from Zoom Lion were busily cleaning the enclaves of the grounds. According to an operations officer at the Waste and Sanitation Company, there are more than 200 workers on shift duties.
After the inauguration, what we are trying to do is that we want to tackle the outside area first. That is the strategy we are trying to employ. The issue is that we have a lot of banks and it's quite a busy area. So we want, and tomorrow is also a working day, so we want to tidy the place and make sure that the place is okay for tomorrow's activity. We are anticipating that we should be able to finish the cleaning of the area. Then we move into the main grounds, which is the Black Star Square, to complete the exercise or to conclude the exercise in there.
Kenneth Kwame Namosi said cleaning started as early as 4 a.m. and is expected to finish by the close of day on Sunday. Meanwhile, at the beach behind the Black Star Square, usually referred to as the Baller Beach, some revelers were busily enjoying a cool morning. One of the lifeguards at the beach said the place was jam-packed on the day of the investiture of the president, but complained about the lack of security and professional lifeguards during occasions such as yesterday's.
The marine police should come around occasionally to protect life and property, especially on holidays when the beach is highly patronized.
Edmond Ni Ayi, who was also at the beach, was however worried about the Osu Castle. He says the place has been left to rot after the seat of government was moved to the Flagstaff House. He called on authorities not to neglect the once pride monument of the country.
The castle is in a bad state, and we, the people living around it, are not happy about this development.
Activities at the beach after the holidays are yet to pick up. Sellers are optimistic, however, about sales in 2017.
Described as the most considerate and a woman of integrity by her husband, Rebecca Akufo-Addo stands tall among women. She's the first lady of Ghana, and her interests include early childhood development, malnutrition, and education issues.
One of the daughters of Justice Jacob Hakimbe Griffith Randolph, The Speaker of Parliament in the Third Republic in 1979, Anne Frances Philippina Griffith Randolph, is a soft-spoken Rebecca Na Okaiko Ekufado, wife of Nane Ekufado. She was born on the 12th of March in 1951. She started her basic school at Achimota Primary School and continued to Wesley Grammar School in Accra and then to a government secretarial school where she qualified as a secretary. She worked at the Merchant Bank in Ghana before relocating to the United Kingdom. She qualified as a legal secretary in the United Kingdom and worked for Clifford Chance and Ashurst Morris Crisp, both multinational law firms. Rebecca Ekufuado and her husband, Nana Adudankwa Ekufuado, have 5 daughters and 5 grandchildren. The couple worship at the Accra Rite Church, an interdenominational congregation. Mrs. Ekufuado has always supported her husband's career and has maintained her firm belief in his love for his country and ability to move Ghana forward.
Let's vote for Nana Addo and the MPP so we can actually experience a new Ghana.
In the past election, she campaigned and supported the New Patriotic Party by reaching out to market women groups and even leading the NPP loyal ladies in a car wash exercise in the Ashanti region. On her campaign trail, she emphasized that Nana Akufo-Addo's presidency will stop corruption and implement policies and programs that would lead to the transformation of the economy and make life better. 65-year-old Rebecca Akufo-Addo spends her leisure in interior decoration, floristry and reading. She loves children and is the patron of Infanta Malaria, a charity organization dedicated to the prevention of malaria in children. As First Lady, she says she plans to champion the cause of the Ghanaian woman and children.
In some more stories, the former chairman of the Christian Council of Ghana and the presiding bishop of the Evangelical Lutheran Church of Ghana, Right Reverend Dr. Paul Kofi Fien, has expressed disappointment over the proliferation of prophecies and false prophets in the country. He urged the general public, especially Christians, to study the Word of God in order not to be swayed by the so-called prophecies.
A prophecy is a prediction of what will happen in the future. It is believed that God sometimes reveals some future happenings to some of his chosen servants. Prophecy has been part of Christian worship for centuries. However, the practice of prophesying is being abused by some supposed men of God. This and other issues prompted the news conference by the Evangelical Lutheran Church of Ghana. The conference was addressed by a former chairman of the Christian Council of Ghana, Right Reverend Dr. Paul Kofi Fien, who is also the presiding bishop of the Evangelical Lutheran Church of Ghana.
It's for every pastor teaching the word of God to his members. Because once they know the truth, they will run away. They won't follow them. But once they don't go to Bible studies and they don't know the truth, they will continue to follow them. So the key is that they should study God's word.
Right Reverend Dr. Paul Kofi Fien said, the practice where some men of God are using the pulpit to preach politics should be stopped.
Use our pulpit to preach God's word. You can educate your members to understand the problems of the nations. Don't be a partisan.
And this is the news live on your All News channel, GBC24 and Ghana Television. We take a short breather here. We'll be back shortly. Don't go away. In sports this evening, final preparations are underway in Gabon's capital, Libreville, as the country prepares to host the 2017 Africa Cup of Nations. With only a week to go before the tournament kicks off on January 14, authorities in the country are rushing to put finishing touches on the four stadiums due to host the tournament.
Gabon is set to play the opening game against Guinea-Bissau in Libreville and will go into the tournament with a new coach held last August that saw Ali Bongo retain power. Gabon's Panthers 23-man squad features the likes of Sunderland midfielder Didier Ndong, African Footballer of the Year Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang, and Juventus midfielder Mario Lemina, who are due to face off with four-time winners Cameroon in Group A. Football fans in the country hope the tournament, being held on home soil, will boost the Panthers' chances of winning the trophy for the first time. This year's edition of the biennial tournament will be held for 3 weeks and ends on February 5th.
In the arts segment, it was a Saturday and a day of rest. So after the investiture, many who turned up to watch the ceremony simply took it easy as they went through some happenings around the Black Star Square.
A few hours after the inauguration of President Akufo-Addo and his vice, party sympathizers still hung around the venue. These buses, which conveyed people from northern Ghana, were all set to return to their various destinations.
Invisible!
Survivors!
Invisible! All these men are from invisible forces, from the northern region. So we came to see how the swearing-in is going to be done. At least we are happy and we want to see the working.
All along the route to the Black Star Square, business was brisk. The scene at the Nationalism Park was akin to a food bazaar and picnic. Abdul Musa was busy painting faces for a fee.
Every event I've been doing this anytime, but this special one, this is special one for me. Today I've make it. I make a lot of money and I appreciate it. I like what I get.
We came to celebrate the victory of NPP and we are so excited and very, very happy that he is now our president. We love Danado very much.
Some NPP sympathizers said they will continue with the celebrations in their homes even though the ceremony is closed.
They were there in their numbers to add to the fanfare and merrymaking at the Black Star Square on Saturday morning. Former president, foreign dignitaries, invited guests, and the man on the street all lent support to the colorful investiture of President Nana Addo, which earned Ghana's Democratic March a gold star in the eyes of the world.
This was a resplendent platform of dancing, drumming and singing. Proudly on display was a kente cloth matching their respective traditional sandals. The president himself was decked out in his unique kente cloth with ahenema, and the vice president in a white agbada. First Lady Rebecca was also adorned in a patterned kente cloth. Wife of the vice president, Mrs. Samira Baumia, was also colorfully decked out for the occasion. But take a look at these women and their different kente clothes. The traditional leaders also added a touch of beauty to the occasion.
Ye
ana wa obetumi aye wa gudie ne bia ka ho wo dia akora woman no so oman bia wo wo mu a ese wo ye densoa eye wo a wo hwe oman no so no ese wo ye densoa nti aya fa de e wo ho mayen fitetetetetete.
It was a good blend of southern and northern traditional outfits on display in a variety of styles.
It's a northern regalia. This is the way chiefs up north dress. You, as a chief, when you are to be crowned as a chief, this is the way they normally dress you. So from the day of your enskinment onwards, you are expected to maintain that unique dressing of a northern chief.
For the Ghanaian, this was a time to drop all partisan and tribal walls in favor of cultural heritage.
And that's it for the arts and entertainment segment of the news. We'll be right. It's still the news live on GBC24. To the presidency now. And President Nana Akufo-Addo was in Chebbi, his hometown, for a Thanksgiving service a day after his investiture. President Akufo-Addo paid tribute to the heroes of the political independence in Ghana, as well as his predecessors, and promised to continue from where they left off towards the development of the country.
The interdenominational service held at the forecourt of the palace at Chebbi was organized by the Ochinhene Osajifu Amwetia Foripenyi, along with a Christian Council of Churches in the Eastern Region. The service was attended by parliamentarians, traditional rulers, religious leaders, queen mothers, and members of the diplomatic corps. Others include stalwarts of the party, including former President John Ejekun Kufuor and Vice President Dr. Mahmoud Baumia. Delivering the sermon, the head of the Church of Pentecost, Apostle Pokonyina, said most people crave material possession instead of spiritual wealth. This, he says, leads to exploitation.
How can government make capitalism important or beneficial for their own people? It's up to government to work it out to suit their cultural environment, their national environment. Because the Bible speaks against dishonest gain. If internationally petrol, fuel, gas is being decreased, why should the nation increase it? That is unjust principle and unjust activity.
The Ochinhene Osajifu Amwetia Foripenyi said the interdenominational service was to thank God for the victory. He called for an attitudinal change from the citizens in order to move the country forward.
The task of managing any African nation is not for the faint-hearted. Neither is it for those who are unwilling to make hard choices. For those who will compromise on issues. For those who will defend status quo, it is for those who have the audacity of courage to change. And the change we're talking about is not changing of just personalities or party A to party B, a revolutionary change of our attitude as citizens, a change that will make it possible for a no-name child in this part of the world to rise up and become somebody.
President Nana Akufo-Addo paid glowing tributes to the political heroes from Chebbi. He said he and his team are ready to serve the interests of Ghanaians.
The ambassador of Babidi Ghana saw my whole soul. Yeah, ba and Yababa Som on my Ghana. The BBI, young fair no ACNE. Young fair no CNE, so say. Yeah, Bassia Babbe Som Ghana. And now, why would you be allowed to tell you what before? Because I could find a microphone on the corner. My gun of whom who's a mpa. Let me be papa be where you're mounting here. Yes, so ya pray. Sahano.
Keep watching the weather report, and I'll see you same time right here only on GTV. Do you have a good night?
And that's it for the news. Thank you so much for watching. We'll be back at 10:30 with news tonight. But coming up shortly is a talking point, and we are discussing building national cohesion. Do stay with us.